Hello there, my name is Chris Palmer. In today's Black Hat Google Maps ghost traffic video, what I'd like to share with you is my ghost traffic technique that I've been deploying on my own profile simply to see if I could start forcing traffic to a profile without ever clicking on it, without ever going to it, just like a ghost would do. So I don't want to waste any time. I want to give you the overview of this strategy. If you want a more in-depth guide, check us out at www.seomastermind.org, where I go through the entire process to the moon and back. But with that out of the way, let me go ahead and give you the overview of exactly how this works. I'll give you every piece that you're going to need here. So first and foremost, I need to share this with you. This is the back end of my profile. So quite simply here, I'll go ahead and refresh this quick so make sure it's up to date. So if you come into your insights inside of your own profile, I just want to share this with you. Now, this is wildly inaccurate. It's quite interesting, really. But with that being said, I want you to take a look at some key metrics. So the keywords that are driving to the actual business. So these are how people are finding my business. Now, if you take a look down the list here, just put your eyes on number 8. I want you to take a look at how odd that is and how that just stands out. There's sentiment words, there's top priority keywords, and there's brand keywords all mixed into one. Chris Palmer Marketing, all in caps, and then lowercase, SEO services company top best. Now, that's a quite strange string to have start coming into a business, along with a few others, but I won't point those out in this particular video. But I want to point that one out just to make it make sense for you. Now, with that being said, if you take a look here at this traffic, I want you to come on over to my actual business listing where I can share with you how the ghost traffic strategy works. So if you come over here to where your photos are, every photo that's inside your business listing, your Google business profile listing, is housed on a server. All right. Now these images, they're your images, they're in your profile, but they're on Google servers. So if you take a look here, I want to point something out to you. Take a look at the images and the average view counts that my images get. 141, 131, 131, 20, 124, 127, 128, and 462. Now take a look at this image right here. As you can see here, it's for the New York SEO Expert, 462 views. If we come on over here to the serpclick.io, you can clearly see that that same image is sitting on one of my test sites. So this is part of the ghost strategy that I really want to give you today. This is how you can drive ghost traffic to your profile without ever going to it. But Chris, we need more, right? So here's how it's done. So like I mentioned before, every single profile, your profile, my profile, your neighbors, your uncles, your brothers, the plumber down the road, everybody's is housed on Google servers. So you have to go and get the image. Let me share with you how you do that, all right? So if you come out here, you go over to your maps, right? You put your brand name in, you do a brand search for yourself. That's a little bonus, right? But what you're doing is you're going to go over here and see your photos. Once you see your photos, you need to find an image that makes sense for your business, probably one that you've uploaded. So for this instance, I'm going to go ahead and use my New York SEO Expert. Now, what you'll do is you're going to right click if you're using Google Chrome and a PC computer like I am. If you're on another computer, it might be something different. But PC users on Windows, right click if you're using Chrome and then click Inspect. Once you inspect, you just need to know which server and which folder it's in. So if you go to sources, I'll share that with you. Go to sources, go to the IH5 Google user content folder. Once inside of there, go to photos and then find the image that makes sense. Okay. So in this particular case, it's going to be this one right here. You will right click again and then open in a new tab. Once you do that, you now have the image address, just like on your WordPress computer. Like you have all of your stuff in your images and they have their own URLs. It's the same for Google. They have to house that image somewhere. And for your business listing, for this image, it's here. So let's go ahead and grab that. And then what I do is I take a note. Now here's where the magic happens. How the magic happens is through a technique or a strategy that's relatively black hat called hot linking. If you're unsure what hot linking is, what is hot linking. Let me go ahead and just give you a brief definition of what it is. What is hot linking? Hot linking is known as the act of stealing someone's bandwidth by linking directly to their website's assets, such as images or videos. Inline linking is the use of a linked object, often as an image, on a site by a web page belonging to a second site. One site is said to have the inlink to the other site which the object is located. So basically, it's almost like an embed, it's almost like a frame, but you're able to actually call the resource, right, and utilize it on your own assets. Now, because this is your business profile, you should be allowed to call that resource, okay? Now, with that being said, now that you know and understand what hot linking is, it can be relatively grayer, blacker hat, okay? Now, with that being said, you know where the image is. The only other piece that you're gonna need to know how to do is you're going to need to know exactly how to create a hot link. Now, how I'm creating them is utilizing a strategy called lazy loading. Lazy loading is a way to load images last after the resources, because I want them to see the content first, then the image. Okay, that's the only difference here. I'm sure you might have a better way of doing a hot link, but this is how I do it. Now, with that being said, what I want to share with you is there's a couple pieces here inside of the hot link. So I've gone out and I've grabbed the URL, as you can see here, S131KNO, it's this one right here, and I've actually added it into a hot link URL. Now, what do you do with this, and how do you get the keywords to show up inside of your insights? Well, that's the best part. I'm gonna walk you through that right now. So we've created the hot link together. We've gathered the image together. Now, what I'm gonna utilize for showing you this or walking you through this is I'm gonna show you one of my test sites. So this is serpclick.io. As you can see here, we have this imagery here. It's the same exact image that we're grabbing from here, okay? But what we're gonna do is we're utilizing a HTML and CSS template, and we're utilizing it straight from our server. So we're gonna go ahead and log into our cPanel. Once inside the cPanel on our server, we'll go into the file manager. Once inside the file manager, we'll go to public HTML. Once inside a public HTML, we'll right click on index.html. We'll go to edit. And then we're gonna go inside of here. And what we're gonna do is we wanna put it as close to the top as possible. The reason being is Google reads from top to bottom. So we want our header and stuff that's gonna load. And then the first piece of content that it's going to see, even though it's lazy loading, is going to be that image. So let me go ahead and share this with you. What we're gonna do is we're gonna scroll on down the page here. Once we're down the page, we're gonna keep going, we're gonna keep going, we're gonna keep going. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna put it right here. All right, so I'll go ahead and grab this. All right, and I wanna point something out to you briefly. So we're gonna go ahead and just put this in here. So image lazy loading, lazy, SRC equals where the image is. Then the alt text is where a lot of the magic is going to happen. So what we wanna put inside of there is going to be our keyword, something like Chris Palmer Marketing SEO tips, best top company in New York, PENNSYLVANIA, California. Okay, and the list goes on and on. You could put whatever you would like there, and you also want to go ahead and title the video as well. So we have our alt text. You can also add a title if you really wanted to, but for the sake of this video, I'm going to go ahead and just show you the alt text. So once we do that, we will go ahead and just put this at 236. We're going to adjust the width and the height, and we will save that image. Now, what I want to do is I want to go ahead and show this to you. I'm going to go ahead and just do a quick refresh. And now we have our new image here, sitting here, plain as day. And every time you load this, okay, and there's a little bit extra, but every time we're actually sending traffic to the Google My Business listing to that image, okay? Now, there's a magnitude of different ways to utilize this strategy. You can even go the more negative side with this, but the objective here is to get traffic and clicks, user metrics, to your Google business profile. Why? Because it's the most powerful signal that you can send. My name is Chris Palmer. If you're interested in learning more about the ghost traffic strategy or any other strategy at all, if you actually want to know what works, check us out at www.seomastermind.org. We've got 5 more spots left. My name's Chris Palmer. It's been such a pleasure. Thank you so much. If you have any questions at all about anything, never hesitate. Feel free to go ahead and ask in the section below. And I always look forward to seeing you in the next Black Hat SEO, Google Maps SEO, How to Utilize Ghost Traffic video. Have a wonderful day. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.